Hello traders, CryptoEd here. Friday the 7th of June and taking a look at the market. It's time for an update. It's quite some days ago. I think last time I did a video update, it was when Bitcoin started dropping over here and everybody turned bearish, and I showed the bullish setup. I will show you after this one, but this is what most people are looking at, and depending on what trading strategy or charting technique they use, lots of people are expecting more downside, and this is the most logical pattern I see. Maybe the X over here that we do have some more upside towards this level, and in this zone somewhere a rejection and more downside, and but still I don't expect big corrections to the downside. Still think that this level will hold. It's what I explained in my previous video, and I'm still leaning towards that we do see more upside either from here already or from this level. So for the long term, there is not a big difference. On the lower time frame, I do see two different scenarios. First of all, let's go with the herd and follow this setup. And so then we do have a level of attention around 8,200. It depends how this one, let me check how this turns out. Yeah, the problem is some exchanges made a new low here and others didn't, but I would say could do some more upside. I do see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 maybe, but yeah, this level around 8,200 to 8,400 might be the level where everybody's looking for a rejection. But yeah, I'm stubborn, so I'm from nature. So I'm always looking at other possibilities, and that brings me back to the setup I already showed last week. It's this one, and where everybody or many people saying this is the top for Bitcoin, and we do see a bigger correction. I said last week already that this might be the top, this might be the correction. This is where the whales orchestrated the flash crash and they loaded up again here, and that we are now moving to the upside for more upside. And I'm still thinking this is might be a very good possibility, and past days are not giving a very good clue in Bitcoin. Other pairs do give me more, give me a better idea. But we did have this correction. It perfectly landed in our green box, what I have here. And that's the BitMEX chart. This is my combined exchanges chart. And what I want to see now is how this develops in the coming days. Are we going to see here a strong impulsive move to the upside, or do we get more like more kind of corrective moves like this, and so something like, come on, it doesn't work like I want. So let's say something like this, and then more downside. But if we do get here a clean five legs pattern, like, thank you, like more like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and breaking that level, then I would have much more confidence in my bullish view. It's my most bullish view. And if you look just at the horizontal levels, that would mean I want to see a break of this level, a retest, And if that holds, then this most bullish view will play out with a move towards, yeah, most likely 10,000 and next legs, maybe even higher. Let me turn off my Slack. So this is going to be very interesting. What is going to happen? Are we going to see a breakout, retest, and more up, or do we get a rejection? But still, I do think we can have that bounce from these levels, higher 6,000, 7,000, is still what I'm looking for. And why am I bullish like this? Because I am always looking for correlation, and I do see some better patterns in the major dollar pairs. Look, like Litecoin is when we also see this, as this was for me a clearer top. It did have a weird correction, made another leg up. This could be already the start of the next cycle to the upside. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So in Litecoin, we will get more confirmation when you see it breaking that blue line and making the and have a successful retest of that line, and then very likely to bounce more to the upside. And also on lower time frame, I do see here more clean 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if you look short term, I want to see Litecoin making here some kind of correction, and then this could be the breakout. And after five legs, if this is five legs, after five legs you usually get another correction that could be the retest of that line and then bounce. So all in all, Litecoin looks cleaner to me as Bitcoin. And don't forget, Litecoin was also leading the whole Bitcoin move early 2019. It was much stronger and cracked important levels much quicker as Bitcoin did. It was a very good indicator what was going to happen in Bitcoin. Same idea for Ether. It is in some sort of corrective pattern here. We can have the top in here. This is the flash crash in Bitcoin. Starting first leg, second leg, third, fourth, fifth, towards 300 and maybe much more higher. But first, we need confirmation. How do we get confirmation? I do see here also 1, 2, 3, 4 and a 5. Possibly, I do see now that we could make here a little bit bigger correction, yeah, and then possibly the next move to the upside, and that would be 5. And after 5, we do get correction and hopefully retest and bounce. But we didn't break out yet, and that makes it also possible that this, let me go to the 4 hour, that this ABC should be a five leg structure like this, A, B, C, D, E, and that would mean a bounce from this level. So as long as we don't break out, we don't have confirmation for that upside pattern. And the bigger picture is a correction like Bitcoin from here. Where is my drawing tool here? So from, that's the wrong one. I need this one. So a bigger correction from here to here to here. But still, I think these levels will hold, and from here maybe that move. So important to see what is happening in this area. Do we get a breakout here? Would be very good, would fit with my idea in Bitcoin. and then more upside, and same idea in Litecoin. Ripple is also showing that same pattern, where I do think this is the top, this is a correction, not a really a textbook pattern, but it is still following my idea that we could have here the bottom making first leg, second leg, third, fourth, fifth. But here again we need more confirmation, and you could even here also draw more or less the same pattern as an ether, you see. And if we do get a rejection here in this level, in this area, it could even also make this move. So wait for the breakout, and then you have confirmation of more upside. But as you see, all these coins are on a pretty important level, area where it is going to be decided what is next. And as you see here, I do have here also the ABC, could also turn into this ABCDE. And on the end, this looks good. This is a corrective pattern, and should normally lead to more to the upside. One other possibility I do see here, and I had in my charts for a longer time, a long ago, was this. But I must say I do see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I think this is rather unlikely to happen yet. Let me check Ether. Oh, this is messy. I did have that pattern. Well, it's more or less like this pattern, or like this. It's more or less the same. Therefore, it is too early to jump now to conclusions and think we go up from here. We need some more confirmation. We have several scenarios which can play out, and in the dollar pairs, and this needs more confirmation. If we look at the Bitcoin pairs, the majors made some nice steps, and they are perfectly on track what I am charting for already a couple of weeks. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It held this level, it broke out of this support resistance level, it broke, it held here, it moved up and had a nice break out of that pennant. Looking on the lower time frame, you can see it is correcting a bit, not that much yet, and I would say it could do a bit more to the downside before correction, before a bounce. Ether, more or less the same, well, same that I am expecting a bit more down before it can continue the way to the road to the upside. Ripple, here you see the pattern. This is also a nice pennant. We had it yesterday in the group, and the days before I was warning for this breakout. You see here, posted right before the breakout. I was planning to post it on Twitter, but then it already had a liftoff. So it broke out here and did first leg up, a correction, and this is in the area where I would expect a bounce. I just showed you Litecoin and Ether might do a bit more down. That could mean Ripple also a bit more down. But the green box is a potential bounce area. But on the bigger time frame, I think we see more upside. We are in a trade already from here, and we did have one from here. That one is closed over here. There is still a trade open from here, and looking for the biggest swing towards 6,400. And yeah, on track. Stop losses meanwhile on entry, so risk free. And going as planned. EOS, very short. You see here, this is a doodle I drew in the webinars. And yeah, I do think this can still revisit this level. This isn't looking too strong yet for me. After this big 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, it is correcting. It is about to start a reversal, but I think we first should see a retest of this level. If not, then we can see it. If this move, it doesn't look that strong to me. I will look again when we are here. I do have some altcoins to look at with you, which might be interesting. ADA. We had a breakout here. This is also from my webinars, looking for a bounce from this red line, and it does. Let me check the lower time frame. You see it broke out here, retest, and trying to go up now. Looks like a good entry for a move back towards this level, 1361. That is a nice move for about 25 to 30%. AMB is also in our group mentioned, and it is breaking out, breaking that support resistance level here. Wait for a move like this, and then go. If you see consolidation here, retesting this support resistance, and when it flips resistance into support, then you should be in. Targets, I would say this is my first level of interest. Let's see. Another 30% possible. Looks good. Sealer. It did have a nice run. It is in a correction, and that's also what I expected. So I took profit over here, and now seeing this correction, might do a little bit more, possibly a retest. That is not a I was looking for a horizontal. I think this is more or less the level you should look for a bounce around. Let's say 225 to 215. That should give a bounce. And if you are very lucky, you can rebuy here in this area. And if it does a retest of that level, but I doubt it will go that low. Fetch the same. Also taking profits and letting it correct. It could make this move, and you notice, you see the correlation I showed you in the beginning, the Ether, Litecoin, Ripple pairs, also in Bitcoin, they also show a correction. And if you see it in those bigger pairs, you can rely on it. You will see it also in most of the smaller altcoins. So Fetch, I would say, a bit more down, and keep a close eye on this line. It might break out earlier and start bouncing earlier. Maybe we do get something. We get that it holds this yellow level, but I doubt. Normally I would want to see an ABC, and I would try to get in around this level. Quarkchain, one of my favorites for a long time. It's very good to trade. It did have a very big pullback here, went into accumulation, still happening. It did have a nice move up. It broke here a horizontal level. Where is it? Here. Yeah, this is from a team member. I'm laughing about the indicator, a plepticator. I don't know what that is, but it looks funny. We do have a trade open here from these levels here. And you see it is here on a support resistance level, which is over here. And if I look at the lower time frame, we could see something like this. And then that would be a bull flag, and then I would look for a breakout to the upside. So I wouldn't jump in right here when you see this bouncing up a bit. I do think it can have some more downside. Which is this one? This is Zilliqa. I don't have it in this list, but it's also showing a good swing to the upside. You see we are already in since this level, 241, but I think there is a nice opportunity to get back in, because I have the idea that this is quite toppy. We do have here divergence, and I would say we'd see some correction before more up. Not sure yet, because look, this is still going. It did start here a candle down, up again, but this feels to me that it's quite toppy, and I'm certainly not entering here, but I'll wait for a move back to, let's say, 280, 270. If it gets there, then it might be very interesting to get in. There is a lot of hype right now around Zilliqa, lots of rumors. In 2 weeks, I think they have a conference, so that could give some nice swings to the upside. Final one I wanted to show you is 0x. And look, 0x is in a nice pennant. It is, yeah, sort of consolidating. And this indicator tells me there is accumulation going on. And this volume indicator, there's accumulation, but I do also see here red looking for a reversal. That would mean more or less this move, and that would perfectly fit in the bigger picture that you see here, this pennant holding and then breaking out to the upside. No entry yet. Look, keep an eye on how this move goes down. If it bounces, then like this, if it bounces here, then you wait for the breakout and buy the retest. And next opportunity is this horizontal level. But look at the bigger picture. That is why you should wait for a breakout. There is a big downtrend, and this could be a continuation pattern. And those pennants, they can break out to both sides, so-called bilateral pennants. So that's why you have to be careful and absolutely wait for that breakout and a retest. Because we all know what happened in the past year. Everybody was thinking everything is going up again, and we only went down. So you don't want to be in such a trade which does another 30-40% to the downside in a couple of weeks, like happened here. This is a downtrend. We do have here a nice bounce. Gives me the idea this is more bullish and not just a consolidation pattern before more down. This move here and the correction here gives me the idea this is breaking out to the upside. So if you are looking at, if you want to get in, place an alert on this trend line and wait for that breakout. Yes, I hope all is clear. Wish you happy trading, and it's Friday, so good weekend to all of you, and have fun. Bye bye.